Like that we've been rejoined by all the members of our jury panel. Ladies and gentlemen, from time to time, I need to speak to the lawyers on issues that are oftentimes complex and require extensive argument. Don't necessarily require it, but we get extensive argument. And I think it's easier for me to have you step into the jury room so you can use the facilities there and stretch a little rather than for us to stand over at sidebar for 20 minutes to half an hour. That's the reason for that. The reason for our discussion today was that last photograph that you were shown, People's Exhibit Number 9. I am not going to allow the use of that photograph despite the fact that you've already seen it. I know it's difficult to unring a bell, but I'm going to ask you to disregard what you saw in that particular photograph. The reason for that is there is no foundation. That's a legal finding. There is no foundation for that photograph. In other words, we don't know the date, time, and place where that was taken, by whom, and what it purports to depict. All we have is the picture, and we can't tell the place, date, and time, and who was there who took it at this point. So I'm going to ask you to disregard that photograph, and we'll continue with the testimony of Denise Brown. Ms. Brown, would you resume the witness stand, please? All right, Ms. Brown, you're reminded you're still under oath. Would you just pull the microphone close to you, please? Thank you. Mr. Darden, you may continue. Yes, you may.
Ms. Brown, showing you what has been marked People's 10 for identification, is that a photograph of your sister, Nicole?
Yes, it is.
And is that a photograph that you've seen before?
Yes, it is.
Do you know who took that photograph?
I did.
Do you recall when it was that you took that photograph?
Yeah, it was right after the 89 incident.
Was it on New Year's Day itself?
Yeah, I think it was a couple of days later.
That photograph depicts certain injuries to your sister, is that correct?
Yes, it does. Okay.
The swelling over her right eye, that isn't how she usually looked, is it?
No, it's not.
Ms. Brown, showing you People's 11 for identification. In this photograph, your sister has her right arm raised, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. Do you see any injury to her right arm there?
Yes, I do.
What do you see?
A bruise, big bruise.
And directing your attention to the right side of her head, around her forehead. Do you see any injuries to the right side of her head?
Yes, I do. Okay.
That's not how she usually looks.
No, it's not.
You told us a moment ago that you took these photographs, is that correct?
Yes, I did.
Okay. Would you describe for us, please, the circumstances that led to your taking these photographs?
Nicole asked me to take them for her.
Sustained. Not sustained. Next question.
How many photographs did you take of her that day?
Overruled.
Are we asked a question? The day that you took the last two photographs you just saw here, 10 and 11.
Right.
Okay. That day, did you take any other photographs of your sister?
All right. Without the court reporter first.
Ms. Brown, are these the only two photographs you took?
Yes, they are.
Okay. And after you took those photographs, what did you do with them?
I gave them to Nicole. She took them.
Okay. And did you know back in 1989 whether or not your sister Nicole had a safe deposit box at Union Bank?
No, I did not.
Ms. Brown, last week we played for the jury an audio tape of an incident that occurred in 1993. Have you heard any portion of that audio tape?
Objection.
Have you heard any portion of that audio tape?
I don't think so.
The 1993 tape of the incident at Gretna Green?
I don't know.
I'm sorry. I didn't hear the answer.
She indicated, no, she doesn't believe that she heard it.
Okay.
Is that correct, Ms. Brown?
Yes.
Mr. Darden.
When was the first time you learned that something had occurred on October 25, 1993 at Gretna Green?
Objection denied.
Sustained.
Were you present at your sister's house on October 25, 1993?
No, not that I remember, no.
Married to the defendant in February 1985, is that correct?
Yes.
And since that date, did you on occasion socialize with the defendant?
Yes.
And did you socialize with the defendant and your sister?
Yes, we did.
Okay. You went out together?
Yes.
Went to clubs?
Yes.
What kinds of places and what kinds of things did you do with the defendant and your sister?
Overruled.
We used to go out to dinner. We used to go dancing. We did family vacations, ski trips. We did a lot of things together. We were a family.
And you considered the defendant part of your family?
Absolutely.
So not everything that happened between your sister and the defendant was bad, correct?
No, not at all.
Lots of good times.
Yeah.
Did the defendant own any property in Victoria Beach?
Yes, he did. He had a house.
I'm sorry?
He had a house on Victoria Beach.
Okay, a beach house?
Yes.
Okay. And were there occasions when your sister would go down to the beach house on Victoria Beach without the defendant?
Yes.
And would she bring the children sometimes?
Yes.
And sometimes the defendant would come with her, is that right?
Yes.
Okay. And your family, the Brown family, did you live close by or near the beach house?
Yes, we do.
During those occasions when your sister came to the beach house alone or without the defendant, did you meet her there on occasion?
Could you repeat that? I'm sorry.
On those occasions when your sister came to the beach house alone, would you meet her at the beach house on occasion?
Oh, sure.
Okay. And would she come to your family home alone and without the defendant on occasion?
Oh, yes.
And on some of those occasions, would you hear from the defendant?
Yes, we did.
He would call?
Yes, he did.
And was there any pattern to the number of calls you would receive from the defendant on those occasions when your sister came to the beach house or to your house alone?
Objection, cause for speculation, foundation.
Sustain.
On those occasions when your sister would come We'll strike that. Strike that. On those occasions when your sister was in Laguna Beach or Victoria Beach alone, would the defendant call?
Yes, he would.
Would you answer the phone?
Sometimes, on occasion.
And on those occasions when you answered the phone, was there a pattern as to what the defendant would say to you?
Sustained.
Do you recall when it was that the defendant bought the house in Victoria Beach?
No. I don't recall.
Okay. Do you recall if it was in the 80s as opposed to the 90s?
Yes, 80s.
Okay. Do you know the exact date each and every time your sister came to Victoria Beach?
Do I know the exact date?
Yeah, the exact dates. Okay. Were there many occasions?
Yes.
Can I have one moment, Your Honor?
Certainly.
Was there ever an occasion when your sister came to Victoria Beach alone and the defendant didn't call?
No.
No foundation.
All right, that last question to answer will be stricken. Jury's to disregard. Mr. Darden.
Can we approach for a moment, Your Honor?
Yep. With the reporter, please. All right, thank you, counsel. Mr. Darden, you may continue.
Ms. Brown, you have a niece and a nephew by your sister, Nicole, is that correct?
Yes, I do.
Okay, and that is Sydney and Justin?
Yes.
Okay. Do you recall in which year each of your niece and nephew were born?
Sydney was born in 1985, and Justin was born in 1988.
I take it that your sister gained weight while she was pregnant.
Yes, she did.
And after each of those pregnancies, did she keep the weight on for a while?
Yeah.
While she was actually pregnant, did you ever hear the defendant comment about her weight?
Yes, I did.
What did the defendant say about your sister's weight while she was pregnant?
Sustain.
This is the defendant's statement, Your Honor.
Oh, I'm sorry. Overruled.
Could you repeat that, please? Okay.
What did the defendant say about your sister's weight while she was pregnant?
He used to call her a fat pig. He used to comment like this all the time.
Okay, he'd make hand gestures?
Yes.
Holding both hands apart, as you just indicated on the record?
Yes.
And did you actually hear him call your sister fat pig while she was pregnant?
Yes.
And after she had each of the children, would he make similar comments about her weight?
Yeah, he hated fat women.
He would tell your sister that he hated fat women?
He would always comment about her weight.
And you would be present on occasion when he made these comments?
Yes, I was.
Did your sister Nicole react in any way on those occasions when the defendant would call her a fat pig or say that he hated fat women?
At one point, she didn't care how much weight she gained. She just wanted him to leave her.
Can I have one moment, Johnnie?
Yes.
Ms. Brown, who else would be around on those occasions when the defendant made these comments about Nicole's weight?
Oh, God. I don't know. My mom, she heard it too. My sisters, other people.
And when the defendant would make these comments about your sister's weight, did her demeanor change at all? From what you could see?
She would just sort of sit there. She really didn't do anything. She just got quiet.
And on those occasions when the defendant would call your sister these names, did you say anything to him?
Oh, I don't remember.
At some point, your sister lost the weight, is that correct?
Yeah, she looked great.
Do you recall when it was that she lost the weight?
It was a couple of years ago, almost 3 years ago, I guess.
And do you know how she lost the weight?
Yeah, she started running and eating really healthy.
By the way, the comments the defendant made about your sister's weight, were those comments made in public?
Yeah.
On those occasions when you saw the defendant, and this is after your sister lost the weight, did his attitude about her weight change at all?
Yeah. He loved it. Look at her. She looks great, doesn't she? She's mine.
That's what the defendant would say?
Yeah. She was always like a possession.
Well, during the years when she was carrying the weight, did he ever say, look at her, doesn't she look great, she's mine?
Oh, maybe when she was dressed up or something, who knows?
I need the court's guidance on one matter. Can we approach a sidebar for a moment?
Madam Reporter, how's your paper supply? All right, thank you, counsel. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a brief 20-minute recess at this time. I'm going to ask you to step back into the jury room. We'll resume and go through to the lunch hour. Please remember my admonition to you. Don't discuss the case amongst yourselves. Form any opinions. Allow anybody to talk to you about the case. We'll see you back here in about 20 minutes. All right, Ms. Brown, you can step down for the moment, please. All right, good morning again, Ms. Brown. You're reminded you're still under oath. Mr. Darden.
Ms. Brown. You described for us the incident after you went to the La Cantina restaurant, and you also described the incident at the Red Onion. And you also testified that you consumed alcohol on each of those specific occasions. Is that correct?
Yes, I did.
And on those occasions, did you have a drinking problem?
Yes, I did.
You're a recovering alcoholic?
Yes, I am. Sober for over a year now.
During January of 1992, did your sister leave the defendant?
Yes, she did.
Overruled.
And did she move somewhere else?
She did.
And where did she move to?
To Gretna Green.
Okay, and did you visit her there?
Yes, I did.
Okay. How did the defendant react to your sister leaving him in January 1992?
Objection, false speculation. It's vague.
Did you ever discuss with the defendant his feelings about your sister leaving him in January 1992?
Let me talk to counsel with the reporter, please. All right, Mr. Darden, you may continue.
Ms. Brown, directing your attention to June 12, 1994. On that day, was a recital held for your niece, Sydney?
Yes, it was.
And where was that recital held, if you recall?
Paul Revere School.
And that's a middle school in Brentwood?
Yes, it is.
It was a dance recital, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And did you drive up from Laguna Beach to attend the recital?
Yes, I did.
Did other members of your family also drive up from Laguna Beach to attend the recital?
My whole family did.
That would include your sister Dominique and Tanya?
No, Tanya wasn't there. Dominique was, my mom and dad. My son. Dominique's son.
I'm sorry, your son and who else?
My son and Dominique's son.
Okay. Did you go to the recital?
Yes, I did.
Did your sister Nicole go to the recital?
Yes, she did.
When you arrived at the, strike that, was the recital held in an auditorium?
Yes, it was.
Okay. Now, when you arrived at the auditorium, was it full of people?
Packed.
Okay.
Yes.
And were you given a program for the recital?
Yes, we were.
And so did you know when and at what point Sydney would be dancing in the recital?
We did. She was second to last. Okay.
And how long was the recital scheduled to last, if you know?
I think it lasted longer than it was supposed to. I remember that. It lasted a couple of hours.
Okay. Now, when you and your family first entered the recital hall, did you take a seat?
Yes, we did.
Okay. Did your other family members take a seat?
Yes.
Was the defendant with you when you first arrived at the recital hall?
No, he was not.
Okay. And when you and your other family members took a seat in the auditorium, were you able to sit together in the same row?
No, we were not.
So the group was broken up then?
Yes.
Okay. Different people sat in different rows?
Yes.
Okay. Now, at some point, did the defendant arrive?
Yes, he did.
And when he arrived at the recital, did you greet him?
He walked in on the other side and got a ticket from Dominique, and he kind of waved like that.
Okay, kind of waved to you?
Right.
And did you acknowledge his wave?
I just smiled.
Okay. And your parents were there, you say?
Yes, they were.
Did the defendant greet your parents?
Yes, he did.
And how did he greet your parents, if you recall?
He went over and he was talking to them. They were sitting one row in front of me.
Did he also appear to greet your sister, Tanya, when she gave him the ticket?
Tanya wasn't there. It was Dominique.
I'm sorry, Dominique. Did he also appear to greet her?
Appeared so.
Did he greet Nicole?
No, he did not.
Did the defendant say anything to Nicole that you heard?
No.
Was your sister Nicole seated to any other member of your family?
Nicole and Dominique were in the back, in one row behind me. And over about three or four seats.
Okay. And were they sitting directly next to each other?
I think so, unless there was a child in between them.
And so the defendant greeted Dominique, but he didn't greet your sister?
He didn't greet Nicole.
And when he greeted you and your sister Dominique and your parents, what was his demeanor?
He had a very bizarre look in his eyes. It was a very far away look.
Excuse me, counsel. Objections overruled.
Thank you. You said he had a bizarre look, a faraway look?
He had a very faraway look. It was actually really kind of spooky. It was a frightening look.
Was he smiling?
No. No.
Can you describe for us physically his physical demeanor at the time?
He just had a very different look about him. It wasn't like OJ just walking into a place and being, you know, hey, here I am, you know, kind of sure of himself type of attitude. It was more of a like a glazed over, kind of frightening, dark eyes. It just didn't look like the OJ that we knew.
Have a moment, Your Honor. Did he always have this glazed over look, that is, throughout the time he was at the recital that you saw?
Well, I wasn't watching him the whole time.
Okay. So the look you described for us a moment ago is the way he looked when he walked in and greeted your parents?
He was talking to my parents, which was right in front of me, so I was able to look at him. Okay. And then he sat behind me.
So did you turn around and look at him during the time that he was sitting behind you?
Yeah, I talked to him.
Did he appear happy and cheerful?
No, not at all. Actually, the only thing that he said to me was that he was here and he had to jump on a plane to Chicago.
And when the defendant sat behind you, did he sit directly behind you?
Yes, he did.
Did he remain sitting behind you?
No, he did not.
He got up?
Yes.
How long did he sit behind you before getting up?
Oh, I'm not really sure, long enough to say those things. But then he got a chair and put it in the corner by one of the back doors. And he stuck the chair in the corner away from all the auditorium seats.
Well, had you said something to the defendant that might offend him?
No.
Did he tell you why he was taking a chair and taking it to a corner of the auditorium and sitting there away from everyone else?
No.
He sat in that chair in the corner of the auditorium?
Yes, he did.
He sat there alone and away from everyone else?
Yeah, I guess somebody went up and talked to him, but the majority of the time I just saw him there by himself.
What was he doing as he sat there in the chair?
Every time I turned around, because my son went outside to play with the rest of the kids, every time I turned around, he was staring at Nicole.
Talk to him, that is, while he was seated over in the corner in a chair alone?
No, I did not.
Was there ever a break in the a break or
intermission?
Was there ever a break or an intermission during the recital?
God, it was so long. I think there was a break, yeah.
Did you leave the auditorium? Do you recall?
No. Only at the end.
Okay. Do you recall if Nicole left the recital during the intermission?
I don't remember.
Did you ever see the defendant move the chair out of the corner?
No, I did not.
Did you ever see him get up from that chair in the corner and walk away?
No.
Okay. How long, if you recall, did the defendant sit in that chair in the corner and stare at your sister?
Oh, I don't know. I was watching the show. It was just every time I looked back to look for the children, that's when I would see him staring at her.
Did you point this out to anyone?
No, I didn't. No.
At some point, the recital was over, is that correct?
Yes.
And did you and Nicole and your mother and father leave the recital hall?
No, actually, they left first, and my mom and dad and myself, we stayed there and we watched the very last show, the very last dance.
Okay. Your nephew, Justin, was in the auditorium, is that correct?
Yes, he was.
Okay. Did he visit with his father, the defendant?
Yes, he did.
Okay. And did everything seem as normal and okay with the defendant and Justin?
Yes, seemed to be.
Did you ever see Justin with the defendant while the defendant was sitting in the corner?
I think Justin was sitting on his lap.
Now, had you and your parents and your sister planned to go somewhere after the recital was over?
Yes, we did. We were going out to dinner.
Okay. And where were you planning to go?
We were going to Mezzaluna restaurant.
And as you left the recital hall, did you see the defendant?
Yes, we did. We walked out with him. Or actually, he was outside, and we met him as soon as we walked out the door. And we walked to the front of the school with him and a friend of his.
Did he give his daughter, Sydney, anything?
I didn't see him give them to her, but he had given her some flowers.
Did you say anything to the defendant as you left the recital hall?
I don't know if I said anything, but there was conversation going on.
Okay. You heard the defendant talking?
Oh, yeah.
Who was he talking to?
My mom, my dad.
What did you hear him say?
Ron. I don't remember. It was just about we're going to the restaurant, and I'm not sure what else.
Did you invite the defendant to go to the Mezzaluna with you and the rest of the family?
No, I did not.
Did you hear anyone else invite the defendant to go to the Mezzaluna?
No, I did not.
I take it that you and your family and the children got into your cars and vans and the like?
We got into the cars and we drove over to Mezzaluna restaurant.
Okay. Did the defendant go with you?
To Mezzaluna?
Yes.
No.
Did you have dinner?
Yes, we did.
What did you do after dinner was over?
We got up and we walked out. And Nicole was gonna go get some ice cream with the kids. And we kissed each other goodbye. The last thing I told her was that I loved her. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Brown, do you want us to just take a few moments now?
Do you mind?
Mr. Darden?
Yes, Johnnie?
I asked your witness if she wanted to take a few moments.
I'm okay. I'll be all right.
Ms. Brown, when you last saw your sister, what was her demeanor?
She was happy because we'd made so many plans to go do stuff. We were going to take the kids on a camping trip. We were going to go to Yosemite. We were going to go to Club Med. We were going to just do everything with the children.
Ms. Brown, I see that you're wearing in court today studs on one ear and a dangling sort of earring on the other ear. Is that correct?
Yes.
Sustained.
Can we approach?
Not at this point.
It is relevant. Or you can just let me ask two follow-up questions to relevant to the audience.
Let me. Mr. Darden.
I have no further questions, Your Honor.
Thank you. Mr. Shapiro.
Thank you very much, Your Honor.
Ms. Brown, as you know, have to ask you some questions.
Yes.
In preparation for your testimony, did you properly meet with members of the district attorney's office to go over the areas that you would be questioned on today?
Yes.
And have you done that on several occasions?
No.
How many occasions did you do that on?
Twice.
And did you meet with any other lawyer to go over any of the testimony that you might offer in court today?
No.
You haven't talked to any other lawyer about this?
No.
Other than prosecutors. Excuse me, I'm sorry.
Mr. Darden.
And have you had a chance to review a transcript of the statement that you gave to the district attorney's office and lawyers in January of this year?
Excuse me?
Have you had a chance to see a transcript of the statements you gave to the district attorney's lawyers and investigators in January of this year?
Yes.
And when was the last time you had a chance to review that?
It was maybe about 4 days ago.
And was it accurate, the things you said in that transcript?
As far as I remember, yes.
There wasn't anything that you called to the attention of any of the lawyers that you wanted to change?
Not that I remember.
The incident that you spoke about, and let's refer to it as the alleged Rockingham incident, the first incident when you were there with Ed McCabe.
Right.
Did you talk about that incident with the district attorneys?
Yes, I told them about that.
And did they ask you when this occurred?
Yes, they did.
And did you have an answer for them?
I had thought it was like I didn't know the exact year, but it was like in the mid-80s after I had remembered.
Is that what you remember telling them?
I think I told them at the first that I didn't remember when it was that I would check.
Did you tell them that you didn't know whether it was before or after O.J. had married your sister?
I told them I didn't remember, that I would check for them.
Do you remember telling them that it was either, that you couldn't even recall if it was before or after the marriage?
I did tell them that, but I would check.
And then you checked later?
Yes.
And what did you check to find that out?
Pictures that I had when I was dating Ed McCabe.
Ed McCabe was your boyfriend at the time?
Yes, he was.
And would you describe him as a substantial individual?
Yes.
He's a man who is involved in advertising?
He was at the time, yes.
And he still is?
I think now he has his own company.
And at that time, he was a well-respected man?
Yes, he was.
And you dated him for about 7 months?
I thought it was longer, but...
How long do you recall?
I thought it was over a year.
And how long into the relationship was it that the events that took place in Rockingham were described? How long had you been seeing him?
I don't really remember how long we had been going out.
And prior to going back to Rockingham, you said you had been at some type of restaurant.
Right.
And there was some drinking going on?
Yes.
And you have told us that you had some problems with alcohol in the past?
Yes.
And do you recall what your state of sobriety was that night?
I had had a few drinks.
What do you remember as a few drinks? Do you have any specific recollection?
Of how many drinks I
yes.
drank? No, I don't recall.
Did you feel the effects of the liquor?
Do sure, you remember we were that? All happy.
And then you came back to the Rockingham house?
Yes.
And you had margaritas there at the house, did you not?
We had more drinks at the house.
And would you say that your state of sobriety was at least impaired?
Slightly.
And that would go for the same for everybody who was there?
Yes.
Do you have any recollection that O.J. Didn't like people smoking in his house?
Oh, he didn't like cigarette smoke at all.
And your boyfriend, Ed McCabe, was a smoker, was he not, at that time?
Yes, he was.
And Nicole was kind of a part-time closet smoker, was she not?
I don't know if it was at that time, but yes.
And do you recall there being some words spoken by O.J. to Ed McCabe about smoking in the house and giving cigarettes to Nicole?
No, I don't.
Do you recall any discussion about that at all?
About smoking?
Yeah.
No.
If Ed McCabe's recollection on this issue was different than yours, would you say that that might be a fair recollection?
Sustain.
When was the first time that you had to think back about this incident in the early 80s?
The first time?
Yeah.
Actually, a girlfriend of mine reminded me.
How long ago was that? I'm just trying to get the time sequence, not how you did it, but when did you first refresh your memory about this incident?
It's never left my mind.
When were you called upon to recall that? Have you talked about that? Is that something you've talked about over 10 years with people?
That's when my girlfriend, she said to remember that, remember this. Remember
when was this? That. I just don't want to know the time. About what?
When I told my girlfriend about it.
When your girlfriend told you about it, remember this, when did that come up?
It was after the murders.
So that's some 12 or 13 years later, is that correct?
This happened early 80s, yes.
Have you talked to anyone who was at the Rockingham house about that incident since the time that you were there at Rockingham?
There was only the four of us there.
Okay. Have you talked to Ed McCabe about it?
I did.
When did you talk to him about it?
I called him gosh, I'm really bad with time. Maybe a month or two ago.
And was his recollection different than yours?
Objection, Your Honor. Call for yourself.
Stand.
You told us you spent the night at the Beverly Hills Hotel because O.J. didn't want any of the three of you in his house.
Right.
And that the next day that Nicole came back to Rockingham with Ed McCabe.
She went back to Rockingham.
Did she go back with Ed McCabe?
Not that I recall, no.
And if you recalled that differently, would you have any opinion about that?
Objection.
If you recall that differently, would you have any opinion about that? I guess a vague
Do you recall Nicole leaving the bungalow at the Beverly Hills Hotel with Ed McCabe?
No.
Do you recall how she left the Beverly Hills Hotel?
She left on her own.
Did she have a car?
Yes.
Is that how you got to the Beverly Hills Hotel in her car?
Yes.
And the place you stayed was what they call a bungalow at the Beverly Hills Hotel?
Right.
It's like an apartment unit. It's not really a hotel room.
Right.
I want to now direct your attention to the incident that you referred to as the Red Onion incident.
Okay.
And at that time, you were dating a gentleman by the name of Dino Bucola.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yes.
And he's a pretty special person to you, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
He's a man that you dated for about 4 years.
Yes.
And that you still see him, although not romantically.
Right.
And would it be fair to say that Ed Bucola is a surrogate father to your young son?
Who?
That Dino Bucola is a surrogate father to your young son?
Actually, they're really good pals.
He refers to him as my little buddy?
Yes.
But your son does not see his natural father, does he?
No, he does not.
And the person that he relates to as the father image is in fact Dino?
Actually, no.
Does Dino pick him up on weekends and take him on outings?
He comes and sees him usually on Sunday when he's in town.
How long?
Overall, I think it establishes a relationship with Mr. Bucola, but I assume there's not a whole lot more than
that. No. And for how long a period of time has he been seeing him on Sundays?
It's not every Sunday. It's whenever Dino's in town, he sees him. It's been over... Gosh, he met Sean when he was 3 months old.
And
it's
Sean
been
is,
ever since.
And how old is Sean now?
Sean's 8.
up until recently, you've been living with your parents, with Sean, in Laguna?
I still live with my parents.
You still live with them? And
oh,
that,
yes.
That's been also all through Sean's life?
Yes.
During the time that... Nicole was separated and later divorced from O.J. You told us she had her own place on Gretna Green?
She was living in Gretna Green, yes.
And then she had her own place on Bundy?
Yes, she did.
Did you ever live with her during those periods of time?
On Gretna Green or Bundy?
Yes.
No, I did not.
Did she ever come back home to live with a family?
To live? No.
The incident that you were telling us about at the Red Onion, and you told us a list of people who were there, and I don't want to go over it, but it was about six or seven people.
Right.
At that time, were you also still drinking?
Oh, I was drinking at that time, yes.
And how would you describe your consumption of alcohol?
I said I had a problem.
That can mean different things to different people, and I don't mean to embarrass you, but this particular evening, could you tell us how much you had to drink, if you recall?
Oh, I don't recall how many drinks, no.
Can you give us some type of approximation as to what your drinking pattern would be like?
On that night, we were doing shots of tequila.
And how many shots would you imagine that you would drink? I know it'd be impossible to remember precisely.
That night, I don't remember.
Did you give us any idea?
I don't remember.
How about, did you have any margaritas there?
Yes, we did.
You remember how many margaritas you had?
No. It was in between dancing, going having a drink.
It was a party atmosphere, was it not?
Yes, it was.
And the Red Onion was very crowded?
Yes, it was.
A lot of noise?
Yes.
A lot of loud music?
Yes.
And how would you describe your state of sobriety when you were at the Red Onion?
Happy.
In terms of intoxication, if we use the terms sober being one who had just consumed a minimum amount of alcohol but still would be able to drive, and drunk and intoxicated in between, would you be able to put yourself on that scale?
Well, I would not have driven home.
And isn't it a fact, Ms. Brown, that your boyfriend at the time, Dino, was the designated driver for the evening, and he was the only one who didn't have anything to drink?
Right.
And you've talked to him since about this event, have you not?
We discussed it vaguely.
And his recollection is different than yours, isn't it?
Sustained.
You told us that your sister met O.J. Simpson when she was very young, I believe was 18 years of age?
Yes.
And you're aware, are you not, that just prior to that she was dating another gentleman who was in fact older than O.J. Simpson?
Sustained.
You described your sister to the district attorney as being smart, as being intelligent, and as being very beautiful. Is that correct?
Yes.
Did you also describe her as being independent?
Yes.
Did you describe her as being strong?
Yes.
Did you describe her as being tough?
I may have said those words, I don't know.
Did all those things apply?
Yes.
Did you describe your sister to the district attorney as having a temper and a mouth on her?
Probably.
I take it there are times that even you and your sister had disagreements.
Objection, irrelevant.
Overruled. You can ask a question.
Not very often.
Did it ever happen?
On occasion.
Did you ever say things to her that you later regretted?
Counsel, this is a sister-sister relationship, siblings. Doesn't tell us much.
Well, husband-wife.
That's the whole continuum.
Thank you, Your Honor. I just was trying to bring out volatility in relationships,
no,
even among
no.
family members.
All right, let's move on.
Thank you. Did you, from time to time, meet friends of O.J. Simpson and end up dating them?
Who?
Anyone, any of his friends.
I have dated a friend.
We see counsel at sidebar. Mr. Shapiro.
I'm not quite this thin.
Mr. Shapiro.
Yes. The incident at the Red Onion, there was another friend of Mr. Simpson's there, a football player named Reggie McKenzie.
Yes, he was.
Is he a gentleman that you also have dated and been romantically involved with?
No.
Have you dated him?
Have I dated Reggie?
Yes.
No.
I want to now direct your attention to the incident at the recital.
Okay.
The recollection of events that you have is that O.J. was always behind Nicole?
No, he was behind me.
And Nicole was where in relationship to you and him?
She was one row back and to the left of me, and O.J. was on the other corner to the right of me.
Was he behind her?
I don't think so, because she was at the very last row.
When you say he went to the corner with the chair, was he behind her or not?
I don't think so. I think they were parallel.
Parallel. And your attention was directed more towards watching he and your sister rather than watching the show and the performances?
No, at that time I was concerned about where my son was.
How long into the performance was this?
When they went outside to play? I'm not really sure.
Do you have any ideas to time framework?
Gosh, I really don't know. It was before Sydney came on to do her dance.
Do you remember O.J. leaving without flowers and then coming back sometime later with flowers?
No, I don't.
Did you see him walk in with flowers?
No, I don't.
In fact, you never saw him give flowers to Sydney,
no,
did you?
No, I did not.
And you've told the district attorney that he didn't give flowers to Sydney.
I didn't see him give her flowers.
How much time elapsed from the time that you were leaving the performance to the time that you finally said goodbye to the people outside?
The people, meaning?
Did you say goodbye to people before you got in your car and left? Out in front?
We said goodbye to O.J. and to Ron Fishman.
And how much time elapsed from the time you left the theater or the auditorium to the time that you said goodbye to O.J. and Ron?
Oh, just a minute or two, a couple of minutes.
What was O.J.'s demeanor when you said goodbye to him?
Quiet.
May I just have a moment, please?
Certainly.
Court's permission, we'd like to show a video of Mr. O.J. Simpson at the Paul Revere School just leaving the recital for purposes of impeachment.
All right, have we seen this before? All right. Ladies and gentlemen, given the hour, I'm going to take our recess as far as the jury is concerned. Ladies and gentlemen, please remember my admonition to you. Don't discuss the case amongst yourselves. Don't form any opinions about the case. Conduct any deliberations till the matter has been submitted to you. Don't allow anybody to talk to you or otherwise contact you. And we will see you back here at 1:30. And Ms. Brown, you can step down. Please don't discuss your testimony with anybody else. You're ordered to be back here at 1:30. All right. And you. She testified to regarding O.J. Simpson upon leaving the concert.
I believe she testified that he had quiet demeanor.
That's correct.
Impeach that.
All right. Do we have the tape queued up?
Yes, we do, Your Honor. Will we play it, please?
All right.
Yeah, this is what Mr. Darden gave us. We may have to get our own back.
Well, then it's a good thing we looked at it first.
Yes, I think so.
may be a different tape going, Mr. James.
It's just Darden's tape, you think, James.
I take that as a compliment.
Are we rewinding the tape? Mr. Fertlow, is that what we're doing?
Yeah.
Taken by Mr. Scott Kennedy, an investment broker. He sent a copy to the prosecution back last
July. We never got a copy from him last week.
You will see Denise Brown kissing Mr. Simpson. You see Mr. Simpson kissing Judith Brown. You see again Mr. Simpson laughing and talking with Mr. Lewis Brown. The other gentleman in the kind of red sweater, that's Brown Fisher, was going to be smiling and talking again. The vehicle drove up to Cherokee. That was their son, Mr. Cole Brown, something there in the vehicle. And also, that's Justin, the son of Justin Barnes. It's just taken after the consequence.
We're silent.
All right.
We're silent.